Number 10 is a Canadian native who's appeared on tour with acts including Foreigner and the Kinks. This time is from Bryan Adams. Band whose debut LP spent over 7 months on a British chart as the number 9 hit, The Fix, and One Thing Leads to Another.
And the number one song was Bobby Darin's classic, Mack the Knife.
Yes, that line forms on the right, babe. Not that Mackie's back in town. Look out, old Mackie is back.
Former who once taught speech and drama to junior high school students has the number 6 song. Telephone is the latest from Sheena Easton. At number 5 is a band whose first music video was filmed in the Soviet Union. True is the latest from Spandau Ballet. Continues with a single that's been on the charts for over 5 months. The Safety Dance is at number 4 for Men Without Hats.
I say, we can dance if we want to. We can leave your friends behind. Because your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. I say, we can dance, we can dance. Everything's out of control.
At number 3 is a group whose members played every instrument on their LP Synchronicity, The Police and King of Pain. Jim Steinman, who performed the same duties on this week's number 1 hit, is a ballad performed by Bonnie Tyler. At number 2 is Total Eclipse of the Heart. Who taught himself to play the guitar at the age of 6. Bryan Adams and This Time.
This time, everything is all right. Go away, she's gonna get away. This time, everything is easy any day. I'm gonna make a mind. It's getting rough, about to cut. I've got to say enough's enough.
At number 8 is the second top 10 single from the certified gold album Reach the Beach. The Fix score again with One Thing Leads to Another.
One thing leads to another. Yeah.
Supremes had the number one song, Baby Love.
Number six is a single from an LP that's made the top 10 in Canada, Australia, and West Germany. The Police and King of Pain. Superstar who got her start by winning a talent contest in her native Scotland is at number five. Sheena Easton and Telephone. Continues with a song written by the Bee Gees and recorded by two of today's most popular artists. Islands in the Stream is at number three for Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton.
We rely on each other above, from one lover to another above.
A group whose debut LP went gold in less than a month has a number two hit. True is from Spandau Ballet.
I know this much is true.
Solid Gold's best new artist of 1973 worked as a department store clerk and as a go-go dancer during her early years in show business. Bette Midler had a top 10 smash with Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy. Top new artist of 74 won four Grammys and an Academy Award in that year. The Entertainer became a gold record for Marvin Hamlisch. '75's best new artist has gone on to record seven gold LPs. This Will Be was the first hit single for Natalie Cole.
Presley's soon-to-be number one smash, Are You Lonesome Tonight?
Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
Solid Gold's best new artist of 1976 wrote, arranged, and performed their Grammy-winning debut release. Afternoon Delight was a gold single for the Starland Vocal Band.
Motto's always been, when it's right, why wait until the middle of a cold, dark night, when everything's a little clearer in the light of day, and we know the night is always gonna be here anyway.
new performer of 1977 saw his first three releases all go to number one on the charts. Andy Gibb's first smash, I Just Want to Be Your Everything. Of Honey became the first group ever to have a debut single and LP go platinum. Boogie Oogie Oogie was their first monster hit. '79's Best New Artist composed her first top 10 hit about a member of her backup band, Ricky Lee Jones and Chuck E's In Love.
I've got to see is he here? I look in the pool hall. Well, is he here? I look in the drugstore. Is he here? No, he don't come here no more.
Solid Gold's Best New Artist of 1980 debuted on the pop scene with an LP that earned five Grammy Awards. Ceiling was the first number one song from Christopher Cross. The first female vocalist to have two top 10 singles on the English charts simultaneously was the top new artist. Morning Train is from Sheena Easton. With a debut album and single that both went to number one, Men at Work became our Best New Artist of 82. Their first hit single, Who Can It Be Now?
Here they come.
Appeared in America as the opening act for Fleetwood Mac has the number 10 hit. Dr. Heckle and Mr. Jive is from Men at Work.
Girls Don't Cry.
Whose debut solo album sold more than 4 million copies is at number 6. Lionel Richie and All Night Long. Song is from a British artist who's had number one records in 7 countries. Telephone is the latest from Sheena Easton.
Real.
these two between them have sold more than 30 million records combined for this week's number three hit. Islands in the Stream is from Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton. Moving up six spots to number two is the first American single for a three-man English band. One Thing Leads to Another is by The Fix.
Thank you.